Good morning, everyone. It's Jeanette with Beeble Vintage Designs. Doing another video on flowers, and I'm going to use my favorite colors, sailboat and sepia. That's sailboat in the center, and then I'm going to put a drop of the sepia in the center. The PSI on my airbrush is set at 40, and today I want large petals, so I'm going to use a big drop of alcohol, let it move the ink a little bit. And drying it all the way to the end. I was making sure that the end of my petal is dried so I don't get that round, strange shape at the tip. That's a pretty petal. Let's hope the rest of them go as well. I love the way it just fades, but it's not dry yet. So I know that I've said this 100 times, but for anyone who's watching for the first time, I want to make sure that you know to hold the airbrush more towards you and start blowing. And you'll see that the ink starts moving into the drop of alcohol that you placed. And to get it moving towards the end of the paper, you can start angling it towards the ink. If you want it to stop moving, angle it away from the ink and alcohol. And you can see how it's drying. So you can keep moving it up. Keeping in mind that if you make it face the end of the alcohol, it'll keep pushing it outward. If that's not what you want, then angle it away, but move it up. See, I want this petal to move out, so I'm going to change the flow of the air. And when the end of the petal reaches the length that I'm happy with, I will angle it away. And continue to dry it. And for some reason, my table feels like it's angled, so my alcohol keeps going in one direction. I'm going to have to check that out. Okay, I think I'll do one last big petal here. That turned out a lot bigger than I expected. So I'll finish drying it and then I'll blow another petal over it. Let's see if I can mask that. So I'll put a little bit more alcohol down here. Now, of course, I can't let that be the only dark petal, so I'll try and create a couple more. I think I need one more darker one right here. And one more here. and then I'll be finished. That's really pretty. I like the way the softer petals are on the bottom, or rather underneath, and the darker petals are on top. So now I'm going to decide what direction I want this flower in. I kind of like it like this. I'm going to get my snow cap. Oh no, I am almost out of snow cap. I'm hoping I have another bottle. I'm going to put a little bit more sepia in the center because I want it to be dark. I'll let it spread. Then I'm just going to use a micro brush that I had laying around to soften. You don't want that crusty edge. Okay, let me dry that completely. Sorry, wrong gun. Dry that. Then I'm going to hit the center of this flower with a little Kamar varnish, just a little bit, so that it doesn't absorb the white that I'm going to be putting on it. And I'm going to dry that as well. I'll get a fresh micro brush, tap it into my snow cap, tap some of it off, yeah, I like it better this way. I'm just tapping the center in, nothing crazy. Trying to keep it most white on top, where I want my light to be coming from. I want to make sure that's dry. And I'm going to take my black gel pen and I'm going to do a few little lines here and there. And I'll call that finished. So I'll give you a close-up of the center. I hope that helps. And there's another finished flower. If you have any questions, leave it in the comments. And please give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Also, you can follow me on my Facebook page. And I will leave a list of all the items used in this painting in the description box. All right, enjoy your day. Bye.